To think the Moogles would prove such harsh taskmasters. Forgive me. I did not know you had suffered so in your quest for the horn. I must say, your spirited accounts always come as a welcome change from the arid reports which fill my days. Though I have lived in these lands my entire life, to hear you speak of them, there is much and more I have yet to see. Truly, yours was a marvelous journey. Well, truth be told, when I think back on the sweeping vistas of the churning mists, I do feel some slight pangs of wanderlust. Alas, much as I would like to accept your invitation, I fear my present duties with the House of Lords demand my undivided attention. Someday, perhaps. By your deeds, you have helped us to lay the foundation for lasting reform. The formation of the Republic is but the beginning, for it is not only our system of governance which must needs change. We, the people, must learn to let go of our hatreds and rise above our bloody past. I only pray that I live long enough to see us achieve some measure of success, that I might know the lost did not die in vain. I can still see you there on the steps of faith, striding fearlessly towards the worm. If you could do that, who are we to balk at the challenges ahead? The question of how best to strengthen ties with the other great nations of Eorzea has been debated at length in the Lords and Commons of late. As you may imagine, maintaining stability during this period of historic upheaval is our paramount concern. Nevertheless, we are greatly indebted to the Alliance for their support during the Grand Melee, and it would be remiss of us not to repay their faith in kind. Of course, we owe you the greatest debt of all, and it is my hope that in extending our support to you and the Scions, we might also express our gratitude to our neighbors, nay, our fellow Eorzeans, whom we pray you will continue to protect. The Lords and Commons agree on very little, but not a soul in either house begrudges your order this offer of patronage. For all you have done and will do, we thank you. May I ask a personal question? Now that the dust has settled, what will you do? Not as a Scion, I mean, but what do you want for yourself?
Lord Commander, pray forgive the interruption.
News from House Fulton?
An urgent message for the Warrior of Light. I was instructed to deliver it without delay. Master Thancred returned to the manor a short time ago, bearing an injured maiden. Master Leveur and Mistress Tataru are tending to her wounds, but they like not her chances. Respectfully, my lord, they have requested the Warrior of Light's immediate presence.
You must go to them, my friend, and I shall go with you.
For every ending marks a new beginning. From tragedy and sacrifice, we rise to greet a new dawn, as did she. Only to be drawn unto another battlefield, another cause, as if by fate.
Is that...
Alize, Alphino's twin sister. She ran afoul of the Warriors of Darkness. I had been tracking them since the ceremony at Falcon's Nest. Little did I know I was not the only one. Evidently, she had learned of their activities and attempted to shadow them on her own. Poorly. I rescued her in the Twelves Wood, and together we fled north. But though I made every effort to cover our tracks, they caught up with us on the Ishgardian border. And in the ensuing struggle, Alize took an arrow to the shoulder. It was only after we had made good our escape that I realized it was poisoned.
Thank you for coming so quickly. And you, Sir Emmerich.
Think nothing of it. How is she?
We have done all we can for now. Although the immediate danger has passed, the poison yet lingers in her blood. We came to Eorzea together, hoping to bring salvation to the realm our grandfather gave his life to protect. But when confronted with the bitter realities of its politics and its petty powermongers, she was driven to anger and to doubt. She refused to become embroiled in what she termed Eorzea's squabbles and distanced herself from the Scions. Though she remained hopeful of a brighter future, she would walk her own path. Would that it had not been so perilous. For all our differences, she is as dedicated as any Scion to the salvation of Eorzea. But more than that, she is my sister. To be reunited with her, only to lose her forever! Gods, even to speak the words.
Take heart, Master Alphino. She will be attended by our most skilled chirurgeons.
B- Bear Mistress Leveilleur to the infirmary at once. Apprise Captain Whitecape of the situation, and inform him that she is to be treated as my personal charge.
Alphano, is the Warrior of Light... is she with you? Don't go, there is something I must say. The Warriors of Darkness are in league with the Ascians. Slaughtering the Primals is but the first step in their plan. They make for Xelphatol to bring about the Ruda's summoning and to kill her. You must stop them.
I shall inform the others at once.
Master Thancred, I would ask that you accompany Mistress Leveilleur to the infirmary. Your knowledge of her injuries may well prove useful in determining her treatment.
Of course.
Thank you.
Thank the gods! What happened? So they were unable to see the ritual to its completion. Then Garuda is no longer a threat, and whatever the Ascians and the Warriors of Darkness were planning has come to naught. But we should not tarry. The Knights have secured our path to safety.
Well, well. What do we have here?
You'd better not have killed the Primal without us!
You!
Wait, I know you. Still walking, I see. I could have sworn my aim was true.
Just what is your game? Leading us the long way so these fools could step in and claim our prize?
No, now. Let's not make hasty accusations. By the look of things, the ritual was proceeding as planned. We arrived at the appointed hour. It was they who erred.
It is hopeless. We cannot face them all.
Do mine ears deceive? A boy! So that's the way of it. Twins! You had me worried for a moment there. Know that I will happily make it quicker for you. If you just stand still.
Enough, Jarumul. We wouldn't want to upset the man in white with any unnecessary bloodshed now, would we? You've been awfully busy since we were kind enough to spare your lives.
While you were idly consorting with the Ascians, you mean? Seven hells! What could you possibly hope to achieve?
Should I explain it to you? Very well. Consider it a reward of sorts for beating us here. You know the tale of Hydaelyn and Zodiac, I take it? Of the great sundering and the reflections it created?
Across 10 and 3 they were divided, reflections of the source, each possessed of shards of light and dark.
Just so. One of those reflections, the one nearest to the source, is our home. And we were the heroes blessed with her light. But not all worlds hold light and dark in equal measure. In ours, the power of light was greater by far. So the Ascians, who once threatened our home, were no match. And they fell before us, one after another, till none were left. Victory, we thought. And then came the light. A flood of pure, blinding radiance, annihilating shadow and color and life itself. Ere long, it will consume our world, leaving naught in its wake but blank perfection.
That cannot be. Do you honestly expect us to believe such a story?
Believe what you like. But it has happened before, on a world far removed from ours. The 13th, which was swallowed by the dark and transformed into what you call the Void. Unchallenged light would condemn us to a similar fate. And so we joined hands with our former enemies, and with their aid came here, to the Source. For there is but one way to restore the balance and save our home. The Ardor. Calamitous destruction with the power to break down the barriers between planes and see our worlds rejoined.
You would doom our world to save your own? What would even become of us? Of you?
Enough. I tire of talking. You know our cause. You know what is at stake. We are prepared to do whatever it takes. Are you?
If there is aught you would say, say it. Otherwise, begone. You have no friends here. Alize, how are you feeling?
Well enough, brother. Thanks to the kindness of our hosts. When they told me you had departed for Xelphatol, I found that I could rest. The outcome seemed a mere formality, as did your safe return. Thank you, my friend.
I take it your mission was a success.
As if we needed any further confirmation that they are in league with the Ascians. But to save another world? I think not.
I too thought his story fanciful at first. But it is possible there may be a kernel of truth in all of this. At the very least, none of his claims contradict the Word's account.
You were following these people, Alize. Why?
During my travels, I had oft enjoyed tales of the Scions and their exploits, but after a time, I began to hear whispers of a gifted and theretofore unknown band of adventurers. Adventurers who had supposedly sworn to travel the realm slaying primals in the Scions' stead.
The Warriors of Darkness. And in the course of investigating these rumors, you stumbled upon the Ascians' involvement.
Yes, exactly.
Forgive me, but if these warriors of darkness mean to bring about another calamity, to what end do they hunt primals?
To prompt an escalation. To deepen the Beast Tribe's feelings of helplessness and despair, and thereby drive them to summon ever more powerful gods. And lest we forget, these events do not occur in isolation. With their patron deities being slain left and right, the news of man's victory over Nidhogg must surely have sown panic in the minds of the Beastmen. Tis no wonder they wish to defend themselves.
Power answered with greater power. Death with more death. A vicious cycle fueled by fear and hatred. I know it's like all too well.
Indeed. The Ascians sow discord and desperation, and the warriors of darkness reap the harvest. And so it continues. Yet that is not the extent of their ambitions. The Ascian himself observed that once the powerless realize that the old gods have failed them, they will have little recourse but to look to a new one.
We cannot let that happen.
It should come as no surprise, but Alize and I have uncovered evidence that the Ascians have been manipulating certain parties to ensure that a constant stream of crystals flows into the hands of the Beast Tribes. If we sever these supply lines, we should at least be able to slow the escalation.
Agreed. Kral and I shall journey to Xelphatol and learn what we can of the Ixar's source.
Then I, for my part, pledge to lead a similar investigation into the origin of the Nath supply.
Sir Emmerich?
As a member of the Eorzean Alliance, Ishgard is honor-bound to play an active role in maintaining the security of the realm. You might also say that I have some personal motivation, given the Ascians' dealings with my father. However, I make no secret of the fact that my knowledge of primal beings is scant at best. As such, I should be most grateful if one of your order were to assist me.
Allow me, Sir Emmerich. I have dealt with the Nath before.
Let us consult with Orianja then. Given his dedication to the study of primal beings, I should be surprised if he could not tell us something of value.
Allow me to accompany you, brother. And before you think to refuse, know that I am not the girl I once was. I shall not be a burden. You have my word.
But Alize, you... You are more than welcome. After all, it was you who set us upon this path.
Wait a minute. I'm afraid I can't allow you to leave just yet. Not until you try on the new outfit I prepared for you.
Thank you.